Hello everyone, good morning. Welcome to the session of coordinate geometry. Okay, let me explain today about nature of the triangle. Nature of the triangle, listen to me please. Nature of triangle. Okay, for triangle ABC, this is the triangle ABC. Okay. What are the lengths of the sides? One side length is AB, one side length is BC, another side length is AC, you know. So, if the relation between those lengths of the sides is like this one, if AB square, the length of AB whole square plus BC square is equals to AC square, AB square plus BC square equals to AC square, or BC square plus AC square is equals to AB square, okay, or ABBC, BCCA, or CA square, ABBC, BCCA, CA square plus AB square, CA square plus AB square is equals to BC square, AB square plus BC square equal to AC square, or BC square plus AC square equal to AB square, or CA square plus AB square is equal to BC square, then the triangle is said to be right angle triangle. Actually, this triangle should be like this. This is, suppose that one follows AB square plus BC square equal to AC square condition, then what is the common in these two? B vertex, B point is common there. So, the triangle has right angle at B. That is like this one, AB square, it one follows the Pythagoras right angle triangle, AB square plus BC square, AB square plus BC square equals to AC square, okay. So that is called right angle triangle. So these are the conditions that triangle ABC should be right angle. So for triangle ABC, this is the first point, then the triangle lengths AB, BC, AC follows this one or this equality or this equality, then you have to say then triangle ABC is right angle triangle, right angle triangle, you have to remember this one. So if AB square plus BC square equal to AC square, then a triangle has right angle at B. Suppose here that one follows this condition, this equality, BC square plus AC square equal to AB square, what is the common in these two? C. So, if the triangle ABC follows this condition, this is a right angle triangle having right angle at C. Here, right angle at B. Suppose the triangle ABC follows this condition, that means the triangle follows this condition, that means the length of AB, the length of BC, the length of AC follows this condition, this equality, then this is a right angle triangle, that one has right angle at A. Common is A here in these two. So, if AB square plus BC square equal to AC square, or BC square plus AC square equal to AB square, or CA square plus AB square equal to BC square, then we have to say the triangle ABC is right angle triangle. Okay, so that is there. Next one, second point. If AB square plus BC square, if AB square plus BC square is greater than AC square, have to replace equals to with greater than here. If AB square plus BC square greater than AC square, R is there, but I am writing here and this one holds on the triangle. So AB square plus BC square greater than AC square, and BC square plus CA square, BC square plus CA square is greater than AB square, also we have to write instead of or, here also and. And CA square plus AB square, CA square plus AB square is greater than BC square. Okay, if the triangle ABC, the lengths of triangle ABC, AB, BC, AC follows this inequality and this inequality and this inequality. That one, the lengths of the sides follows these three inequalities, that is the meaning. Here, the lengths of three sides follows this inequality or this, these lengths of this sides, AB, BC, AC follows this equality or this equality. Any one of these three equalities, if triangle ABC follows, then the triangle ABC is right angle triangle. Any one of these. The lengths of sides AB, BC, AC follows any one of these three relations. Any one of these three relations, then the triangle ABC is right angle triangle. But here, the lengths of the sides ABC, triangle ABC, the lengths of the sides triangle ABC, which is length AB, BC, AC, follows this inequality. This inequality, this inequality. The lengths of the sides of triangle ABC follows these three inequalities. Not any one of these three. That lengths of the sides follows these three inequalities. Then you have to say the triangle ABC is acute angle triangle. Okay. Then you have to say, then the triangle ABC is acute angle triangle. Remember this one. Acute angle triangle. Okay, if the lengths of triangle ABC, AB, BC, AC follows this equality or this equality or this equality, that means the lengths of sides triangle ABC follows any one of these three equalities, then you have to say the triangle ABC is right angle triangle. But the lengths of sides of triangles ABC, AB length, BC length, AC length follows these three inequalities. That lengths of the sides of triangle ABC follows this inequality, follows this inequality, follows this inequality. Okay. The lengths of the sides of triangle ABC follows these three inequalities, then you have to say triangle ABC is acute angle triangle. Here any one of, here any one of, that is important, here all three inequalities followed by the lengths of the sides triangle ABC. So one more we have to write here, that is, see, third one, if I am taking instead of greater than, here less than, I am taking if AB square plus BC square is less than AC square, and I wrote here, but here R, okay, R, BC square plus CA square, BC square plus CA square is less than AB square, or CA square plus AB square, CA square plus AB square is less than BC square, then the triangle ABC is called obtuse angle triangle. Then the triangle ABC is obtuse angled triangle. You have to remember. So the lengths of sides of triangle ABC, the length AB, the length BC, the length AC follows any one of these three inequalities, then you have to say the triangle ABC is obtuse angle triangle. Okay, here also the lengths of the sides of triangle ABC, AB length, BC length, AC length follows any one of these three equalities, then we have to say triangle ABC is right angle triangle. But here the lengths of the sides of triangle ABC, the length AB, the length BC, the length AC follows these three inequalities. Here also, here that is important, these three inequalities, the lengths of the sides of triangle ABC, the lengths are AB, BC, AC follows these three inequalities, then you have to say it is an acute angle triangle. But here the lengths of the sides of triangle ABC, AB length, BC length, AC length follows any one of these three, any one of these three. Here also any one of these three, but here follows these three, complete three. Okay, any one of these three here follows all three here, any one of these three here, any one of these three, the lengths of the sides follows, that is right angle triangle, that the lengths of the sides of triangle ABC follows these three inequalities, then it is a acutangle triangle. The lengths of sides of triangle ABC, AB, BC, AC lengths follows any one of these three inequalities, then that one is called obtuse angle triangle. So this is about something, this is something about nature of the triangle. So one is right angle triangle, one is acute angle triangle, one is obtuse angle triangle. Okay, let me solve some riders about this concept. So the first one is, what is the nature of triangle? What is the nature of triangle? What is the nature of the triangle formed by the vertices? A 2, 3. The point A is 2, 3. The point B is 5, 4. And the point C is 6, 7. Okay, what is the nature of the triangle formed by those three vertices is the question there. So first you have to find AB square. Okay, ABC triangle. A is 2, 3, B is 5, 4, C is 6, 7, that is there. So we have to find what about that nature. Okay, is it right angle triangle, is it acute angle triangle, or is it obtuse angle triangle? We have to decide now. Okay, see, AB square, what is the length AB square here? The length AB square is equals to the length AB having square root, root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square, but AB square not contain the square root. Okay, so AB square is equals to 5 minus 2 whole square 9, 4 minus 3 whole square 1. So AB square is 10 by using the distance between the two points formula. Next, BC square. What is BC square? 6 minus 5 whole square plus 7 minus 4 whole square. 7 minus 4 is 3, 3 square is 9. So it is also 10, BC square. What is AC square? AC square is equals to 6 minus 2 whole square, 16, 7 minus 3 whole square, 16, 6 minus 2, 4, 4 square, 7 minus 3, 4, 4 square, 16 plus 16, 32. So what is observation here? AB square 10, BC square 10, AC square 32. What is the observation there? Okay, here clearly AB square plus BC square, AB square plus BC square is 20. That one is less than AC square. We have to write. Is it okay? Okay. So AB square plus BC square plus AB square plus BC square is less than AC square. That means the triangle ABC is obtuse angle triangle by the previous discussion, you know. So what is the nature of triangle ABC? Triangle ABC is obtuse angle triangle in the coordinate system. Okay, let me go to one more problem. So the points given that, one more example, A 2, 5, 2, 5, B is the point 7, 2, B is the point 7, 2, and the point C is -1, -2. The point A is 2, 5, the point B is 7, 2, the point C is -1, -2. So now the question is, what is the nature of the triangle formed by those three vertices A, B, C? To get the what is the nature of the triangle, first you have to find the length squares like this, AB square, BC square, AC square, and then decide by observing those. So what is AB square here? AB square is equals to 7 minus 2 whole square 25 plus 2 minus 5 whole square 9. So 25 plus 9 it is. So AB square is 34, you know. Next, what is BC square here? BC square is equals to 7 plus 1 whole square 8 square 64 plus 2 minus 1 minus 2, 2 plus 2 whole square 4. So 64 plus 4 is 68. 7 plus 1 whole square plus 2 plus 2 whole square 68. What is AC square? AC square is equals to 2 plus 1 whole square 9. 5 minus 1 minus 2, 5 plus 2, 7 square, 49, I think. 2 plus 1 whole square, 5 plus 2, 7 square, 49. 49 plus 9 is 58, it is. Okay, what is the observation there? Suppose we have to adding these two, AB square plus BC square. Surely the adding of these two is greater than this one, you know. So AB square plus BC square is greater than AC square. Okay, by observing this one, what you have to decide? The nature of triangle ABC, AB square plus BC square is greater than AC square. Then you must find two more relations between AB, BC, AC, because AB square plus BC square is greater than AC square. If AB, BC, AC lens follows this inequality, then the triangle ABC should be, then the triangle ABC should be acute angle triangle. Okay, but by seeing this inequality only, by seeing only this inequality, you have to decide the triangle is acute angle triangle or not. So to confirm the triangle ABC is acute angle triangle, we have to observe two more inequalities, you know. Okay, so AB square plus BC square, already I checked. Next, I am taking BC square plus AC square. What is BC square plus AC square? Adding of these two. Clearly, the adding of these two, 60 something plus 50 something is greater than 34, you know. So a BC square plus AC square is greater than AB square. It is okay. Okay, next, we have to observe the addition of these two, AB square plus AC square. By adding AB square plus AC square, we have to add 34 plus 58. Clearly, 34 plus 58 is greater than 68. That means this one is greater than BC square. So AB square plus BC square is greater than AC square. BC square plus AC square greater than AB square. AB square plus AC square is greater than BC square. By observing these three inequalities, we have to decide the triangle ABC is an acute angle triangle. Acute angle triangle. So in the coordinate system, the triangle formed by these three vertices is an obtuse angle triangle. In the same coordinate system, the triangle formed by the vertices of these three is an acute angle triangle. Just you have to observe, you have to notice these all the contents. Okay, let me go to one more concept. Okay, next, let me explain the area of triangle ABC now. Okay, so it is a very, very important and useful concept. Okay, okay, let me go to state the one more theorem now. Let me get into the theorem now. See, that is, the concept is area of triangle ABC. The concept is area of triangle ABC. Okay, see, this is the triangle ABC. This is the triangle ABC. So this triangle ABC having three vertices, A as x1, y1, B as x2, y2, the vertex C as x3, y3. So we have to find the area of triangle ABC with A x1, y1, B x2, y2, C x3, y3. Okay. So the triangle having vertices ABC, then what is the area of triangle ABC? You have to find this area. How much square unit this one has is the question there. So let me get into the theorem by using that. That is, the area of triangle formed by three vertices A x1 y1, B x2 y2, C x3 y3 is the area of triangle formed by the three vertices A x1 y1, B x2 y2, C x3 y3 is, the formula is, that is denoted with delta, is equals to 1 by 2 modulus of delta of x1 into y2 minus y3, x1 into y2 minus y3 it is, plus take abscissa of this one now, x2 into the difference between these two ordinates, x2 into y3 minus y1, plus take this abscissa, x3 into, so taking the abscissa of this one now, right, the difference between these two ordinates. So y1 minus y2. Okay, this is the determinant of this one. It is area. So the determinant value, suppose it is negative, but area is always in positive. So we have to put modulus to get the positive answer. Okay. Okay, so ax1 y1, bx2 y2, cx3 y3 are the vertices of a triangle. Then the triangle area, we have to find the area of triangle by using this formula. Okay, now it is okay or not to find the area of triangle, we have to use this formula. Is it okay or not? First you have to observe. Now see, listen to me carefully please. I have to check, is it okay or not? Okay, proof of that concept. Now let me explain. In the coordinate system, this is the x-axis and y-axis. It is x-axis, it is y-axis, it is origin, you know. So this is the point, this is the point, this is the point. I am taking the point of this one is A, x1, y1. This is the point I am taking B, x2, y2. B. The point B, x2, y2. This is the point I am taking this one as x3, comma y3. You know. So I have to connect these three like this. There is a triangle. So now the question is, what is the area of triangle ABC? Now the question is, what is the triangle area ABC? The area of triangle ABC is this one, we have to prove now. Okay, to get the area of triangle ABC, first I have to drop a perpendicular line from B to the x-axis like this. Okay, we have to draw one more perpendicular line, one more projection from A to the same x-axis like this. I have to draw one more perpendicular line from C to the same x-axis like this. This is okay. In the Cartesian coordinate system, you have to find what is the point here easily, what is the point of here easily, what is the point of there. I have to find easily in the Cartesian coordinate system. So because this is the point B, x2, y2, you have to drop a perpendicular line, you have to draw a projection from B to the x-axis, then that line meets x-axis at some P. What is the point P? It is clear, the point is x2 comma 0. On the x-axis, every point has y-coordinate is 0. So here also, the y-coordinate of P is 0. Here, the point B, x2, y2 covers the distance x2 along the x-axis, and the point B covers the distance along the y-axis is y2. So we have to take along the x-axis, this point covers along the x-axis the distance of x2, so abscess of P is x2, but it is on x-axis, the y-coordinate is 0. So the length is x2. Okay, what is the length of this one? This is y2. This length is y2, you know. This point covers along the x-axis at distance of x2 unit. The same point covers along the distance y-axis y2 units. This is y2, automatically this is y2. So this is the point x1, y1 here. So I have to drop a perpendicular line projection from A on the x-axis. That perpendicular line meets the x-axis at here. Let me take that one as Q. Then what is the point Q? The point Q is that one lie on x-axis. The y-coordinate of Q is 0. The x-coordinate of Q, the abscess of Q is the length of this one. This is the length covered by this point. How much distance? X1. This length is x1. This point covers the distance x1 along the x-axis. That point covers the distance y1 units along the y-axis. It is y1. It is x1, you know. If it is x1, then the point is x1 comma 0, you know. This is y1. Okay, this length is y1, you know. The complete length is. So, in the similar way, suppose I have to take that point is R. What is the R coordinates? X3 comma 0. This length is X3. Then the length of this one is Y3, you know. This length is Y3. Okay. So, here is some construction. Okay. So, we have to find the area of triangle ABC. ABC. So to get the area of triangle ABC, first you have to draw perpendiculars from B, A, C on x-axis. Those three perpendiculars meets x-axis at P, comma, Q, comma, R. Automatically, this is the length x2, this is the length y2, this is the length x1, this is the length y1, this is the length x3, this is the length y3, you know. Now, what is the area of triangle ABC? By seeing the diagram, I have to say area of triangle ABC is equals to area of triangle ABC is equals to, okay, the area of trapezium A, B, P, Q. Okay, first you have to find the area of trapezium, this one, A, B, P, Q. Okay, area of triangle ABC is equals to area of trapezium, area of trapezium A, B, P, Q, area of trapezium A, B, P, Q plus, okay, next, area of trapezium A, Q, R, C, okay, A, Q, R, C, next, this one plus area of trapezium A, Q, R, C. So, first you have to find the trapezium area of this one and then find the trapezium area of this one. So, what we need here, area of triangle ABC, this part, the shaded area you need now. So, we have, what is the area of this one? What is the area of this one? To get the triangle ABC area, so we have to subtract this region area from this complete area. That means area of trapezium ABPQ plus area of trapezium AQRC, then we have to adding those two trapezium areas, you will get complete figure area. In that figure area, suppose you have to subtract this area, this is also trapezium, then you will get the area of triangle ABC. So we have to adding this trapezium area and this trapezium area like this, and then I have to subtract this trapezium area, then you will get area of triangle ABC. So area of trapezium ABPQ plus area of trapezium AQRC minus area of trapezium, one more trapezium is there, area of trapezium BPRC, area of trapezium BPRC, you have to remember. So area of trapezium of this one full, area of trapezium of this one full, and then subtract this part, then you will get the area of triangle ABC. I think you are clear about that one. Okay, what is the area of trapezium formula? You know, area of trapezium is equals to, area of trapezium is equals to half into sum of parallel sides, okay, half into sum of parallel sides and distance between them. That is the formula. Half into sum of parallel sides into distance between them. That is the trapezium area formula. I have to rewrite here this one. So, area of trapezium, is equals to half into sum of parallel sides, into distance between them, into distance between them, this is the area of trapezium formula, half into sum of parallel sides into distance between them. Now we can use this formula and get the area of triangle ABC here, okay, listen to me. Next, so first you have to find area of this trapezium A, B, P, Q. This is the trapezium. What are the parallel lines here? This one BP and this one AQ. So sum of parallel sides means you have to adding BP plus AQ. Okay, first you have to write this one. This is equals to, this is the formula. Okay, next, the step of, the next step of this one, Area of trapezium ABPQ is equals to half into sum of two parallel sides. This is one side, this is another side. What is the length of this one? Y2. What is the length of this one? Y1. Okay, so Y2 plus Y1 half into Y2 plus Y1 into distance between them, distance between these two. What is the distance of this one? X1. What is the distance of this one? X2. So this is the X1 length, this is the X2 length. Then what is the distance between these two? Complete length X1. We have to subtract this length X2. This is X1 minus X2. Okay, the distance between these two parallel lines is X1 minus X2. Okay, X1 minus X2. This is the area of trapezium ABPQ plus area of trapezium AQRC. This is AQRC. What are the parallel lines here? This is and this one. What is the length of this one? Y1. What is the length of this one? Y3. So what I have to write now? Plus half into the length is Y1, this length is Y3. So Y1 plus Y3. Then what we have to write there? Distance between them. This distance between them we have to write now. So what is the distance between these two? This length is X3, up to here X1. So it is the length X3 minus X1. It is the length X3 minus X1. Okay, so I already wrote trapezium ABPQ area and also I wrote AQRC area. Then by adding those two and subtract the area of trapezium, this one BPRC, so minus of half into. In this trapezium BPRC, it is clear these two are the parallel lines. So adding these two parallel sides, Y2 plus Y3, half into Y2 plus Y3, and write the distance between these two. It is the length X3, it is the length X2, it is the length X3. It is the length X2. So the distance between these two parallel lines is, the full length is X3, up to here X2. The remaining should be calculated as the distance between these two lines, that is X3 minus X2, you know. That is X3 minus X2, you know. So area of triangle ABPQ plus area of triangle AQRC minus area of trapezium ABPQ plus area of trapezium AQRC minus area of trapezium BPRC. It is. By taking 1/2 as common, 1/2 as common from those three terms, 1/2 into, then y2 plus y1, first you have to multiplying with x1, so this is can be written as x1 into y1 plus y2 minus x2 into y1 plus y2, I have understood, plus y2, 1/2 common already take. X3 into this one, X3 into Y1 plus Y3 minus X1 into Y1 plus Y3. Okay, already take 1/2 as common. So minus there, minus X3 into Y2 plus Y3 minus is there. Next coming term is also with negative sign, negative of negative plus, minus of minus plus, plus X2 into Y2 plus Y3, it is. I have understood. Okay, then let us move to the next step. Okay, see here. See, so the coefficient of this bracket is X1 here. The coefficient of this bracket is also X1 here. In the ticked terms, we have to take X1 as common. Then what you say? 1/2 into, taking X1 as common. Then what you write? Y1 plus Y2 minus of Y1 plus Y3. So it is clear, Y1 minus Y1 getting cancelled. Then what you have to write? Y2 minus Y3. Okay, X1 into Y2 minus Y3. Okay, just you have to observe the terms containing X2, this one and this one. So just you have to observe the into mark terms. In these two into mark terms, I am taking this X2 as common. Okay, X2 is common. First, you have to write the plus term. What is the plus term here? X2 as common, it is plus term. X2 as common, it is negative term. So X2 as common, first you have to write this one bracket. Y2 plus Y3 minus of y1 plus y2, y2, y2 getting cancelled, then plus y3 minus y1, I have to write here, plus y3 minus y1, okay. Next, remaining two terms of these two, okay, taking x3 as common, what you have to write here? Y1 plus Y3 minus Y2 minus Y3 plus Y3 minus Y3 getting cancelled. Then what it is? Y1 minus Y2. Okay. By the simplification of the above equation, we are getting this one. So, this is what it is? Area of triangle ABC, which is already we stated in the theorem, this one. Area of triangle ABC is equals to 1 by 2 into x1 into y2 minus y3 plus x2 into y3 minus y1 plus x3 into y1 minus y2. This is the area of triangle ABC formed by the vertices AX1 y1, BX2 y2 and CX3 y3. Okay. But it is area. So, area of triangle ABC is always positive. Suppose you are getting the value of this one is negative, you have to change that one into positive by taking mod. So, area of triangle ABC is a formula by taking modulus of this one. Okay. So, then area of triangle ABC is equals to 1 by 2 into modulus of, you have to read, modulus of x1 into y2 minus y3 plus x2 into y3 minus y1 plus x3 into y1 minus y2. So, this is the area of triangle ABC with the vertices AX1, Y1 and BX2, Y2 and CX3, Y3. You have to remember this one. So, to get the formula of area of triangle ABC, we have to use this diagram. In this diagram, first I have to find area of trapezium, this one, and then area of trapezium, this one. By adding these two, you are having complete figure area, and then we have to subtract this trapezium area. This is the step. What is the trapezium area? Half into sum of the parallel sides and distance between them. By using this formula, we have to write these three trapezium areas like this one and then get simplification. We have to reach area of triangle ABC is equal to this one. Okay? We have to remember this one. It's a very, very important and useful. Okay. So, you have to notice some more points by the concept of triangle ABC area. Like this, see, already you know the area of triangle ABC with the vertex AX1, Y1, BX2, Y2 and CX3, Y3, that is area of triangle ABC is equals to half modulus of X1 into Y2 minus Y3 plus x2 into y3 minus y1 plus x3 into y1 minus y2. Already I explained about this one, okay, just now. So, this can be simply you had to written as this is half into, so this term plus this term plus this terms, okay, these are all the symmetric terms, that means it is x1, then next coming term this is x2, in the coming term this is x3, it is y2, it is y3, it is y1, it is y3, y1, y2, symmetric terms coming consecutively there. So, those three symmetric terms coming with addition plus. So, in the mathematics, sigma representation is addition. So, we have to take this one as a formula, 1 by 2 modulus of sigma x1 into y2 minus y3. This one said simply area of triangle ABC. So, what is the meaning of sigma x1 into y2 minus y3? First, you have to write the first term as it is. Sigma is there. So, then put plus there. After that, you have to write the symmetric term. X1 place is replaced with x2, y3, y1. After that, you have to write one more symmetric term. That is x3, y1, y2 like this. Okay, there is only three vertices. With those three vertices, you are getting three symmetric terms. You have to add those three. Simply, that addition of those three symmetric terms can be written as like this. Okay, so you have to calculate the area of triangle ABC by using this formula. So, in the similar way, we have to calculate the area of triangle ABC with also in this formula 1 by 2 into sigma y1 into x2 minus x3. By applying this formula also you can find the area of triangle ABC. Both are same. You have to use this one or this one. Okay. Next, area of triangle ABC, the another formula, area of triangle, to find the area of triangle ABC, there is one more formula, that is half into modulus of determinant of x1 minus x2. Okay, what are the vertices? X1 y1, x2 y2, x3 y3. These are the three vertices you know. Okay, then area of triangle ABC is equals to half into modulus of determinant of x1 minus x2, x1 minus x3. 2 by 2 determinant you have to write here. X1 minus x2, x1 minus x3. In the similar way, y1 minus y2, y1 minus y3. Y1 minus y2, y1 minus y3. First you have to find the determinant value, okay, and then put mod. This also tells the area of triangle ABC. It is, we have to use this formula oftenly. It is easy to find the area of triangle. By using this formula, we have to find the area of triangle easily. Okay, just remember this one also. Next, also we have to write area of triangle ABC. Area of triangle ABC like this. That is equals to 1 by 2 determinant of, just you have to write the first row like this, x1, x1, x2, x3, x1, x2, x3, and repeat x1 here, y1, y2, y3, and repeat y1 here. This also represents area of triangle ABC. It is nothing but this one. How it is? Suppose you have to multiplying these two minus multiplying these two. That means that one gets the formula like this, half into x1 y2 minus x2 y1, x1 y2 minus x2 y1, and then you have to multiplying these two and subtracting the multiplication of these two, and then multiplying these two and subtracting the multiplying of these two terms. So first I already wrote x1 y2 minus x2 y1 plus, repeat the same process, plus what is there, x2 y3 minus x3 y2, x2 y3 minus x3 y2, repeat this, plus x3 y1 minus x1 y3 plus x3 y1 minus x1 y3. Just you have to observe, by taking x1 as common from these two, then x1 into y2 minus y3, nothing but this one. By taking x2 as common from these two terms, x2 into y3 minus y1. Okay, you got? And then you have to take x3 as common from these two terms, x3 as common, then it is y1 minus y2. I hope understood. So this is the formula, nothing but this one. Okay, so to find the area of triangle ABC, we have to use, these are all the formulas in mathematics. Okay, the area of triangle ABC with the vertices AX1 Y1, BX2 Y2 and CX3 Y3, then the area of triangle ABC you have to calculate it by using this formula, or this one, or this one, or this one. Okay, these four formulas represents area of triangle ABC with the vertices AX1 Y1, BX2 Y2 and CX3 Y3. You have to remember. Okay, so, okay, let me solve some riders about the area of triangle ABC. Okay, first example is, find the area of the triangle formed by, find area of triangle formed by, area of triangle formed by the vertices, the first vertex is 4 comma 4, formed by the vertices A 4 comma 4, B 3 comma minus 16, 3 comma minus 16, and the third vertex is 3 comma minus 2. Area of triangle formed by these three vertices we have to calculate here. So I am taking the formula for calculating the area of triangle ABC. Area of triangle ABC, okay, is equals to half modulus of determinant of, I am taking this formula, x1 minus x2, x1 minus x3, 2 by 2, determinant I have to writing here. In the same way, y1 minus y2, y1 minus y3, it is 2 by 2 determinant. Already I noticed this one in the note points, previous note points. Okay, so I have to calculate the area of triangle ABC easily by using this formula. Okay, among all those, 1 by 2 modulus of, this is determinant value. Determinant value should be negative or positive, we don't know. So we have to put mod for safe, because area of triangle is always positive. This is modulus, this is determinant. Okay, you have to understood, I think. X1 minus X2, this is X1 Y1, this is X2 Y2, this is X3 Y3. By applying the formula, X1 minus X2, 4 minus 3, 1. X1 minus X3, 4 minus 3, it is also 1. Y1 minus Y2, 4 minus or minus, plus 4 plus 60, 20. 4 minus or minus, 6. Okay, so this is determinant. Put mod here. Okay, this is determinant, 2 by 2 determinant, this is mod. So this is equals to 1 by 2 modulus of, what is the determinant value? Determinant calculated, 2 by 2 determinant, 1 into 6 minus 20 into 1, 6 minus 20, it is minus 14. Modulus of minus 14, plus 14, 14 by 2. What is the area of triangle? 7 square units. The area of the triangle formed by those three vertices in the coordinate system is 7. You have to remember that one. Okay. That's like you have to do so more problems there. Next, one more. The triangle vertices with the second example in this one. Area of triangle you have to find. Area of triangle formed by vertices. The first vertex is A1 minus 1. 1 comma minus 1. The second vertex is 6 comma minus 6, 6 comma minus 6, and the fourth vertex is 4 comma k. So unknown is there, k. Okay, the area of the triangle formed by the three vertices A 1 minus 1, B 1, 6 comma minus 6, and C 4 comma k is 10 square units, is 10 square units. Then what is k? You have to say. Then what is k? You have to answer that one. K value you have to find there. So already you know about what is the area of triangle. Okay? By applying the area of triangle formula and make that one is equals to 10, you will get the unknown k value here. Okay? So area of triangle ABC is equals to 1 by 2 modulus of x1 minus x2, x1 minus x3, y1 minus y2, y1 minus y3, that is there. So this is the area of triangle actually. That one is given as 10. We have to make this one equals to 10 there. Then 2 tens are 20, it is. So modulus of, what is x1 minus x2? 1 minus 6 minus 5. What is x1 minus x3? 1 minus 4 minus 3. What is y1 minus y2? Minus 1 plus 6. Minus 1 plus 6, 5. Okay, what is y1 minus y3? Minus 1 minus k. Okay, this is the determinant. 2 tens are 20 by the cross multiplication. So, this is minus 5 into minus 1, 5. Minus 5 into minus k plus 5k. Minus of minus 15 plus 15. Okay, mod is there. Okay, determinant expansion it is, mod is there. Mod is equals to 20. So what it is? 5k, 15 plus 5, 20. So modulus of 5k plus 15 is equals to 20, you know. Taking 5 as common, then that should be right. Taking 5 as common, then taking 5 as common and getting 20, right side 20 cancelled. Then we have to say modulus of k plus 3 is equals to 4. Okay, so by eliminate modulus, by the properties of modulus, k plus 3 is equals to plus or minus 4. This implies k plus 3 is equals to 4 or k plus 3 is equals to minus 4. By the way, so k equals to 1 or k is equals to minus 7. Okay, right, good. Okay, thank you.